Hello everyone, welcome back. Today I'm going to show you how to play imported titles on a domestic Dreamcast system without actually modding the system. Today I have three discs here for you guys. The DCX for Dreamcast, which you can just swap games no problem without any additional hardware. The Game Shark Lite, which will require you to have a VMU unit with extra space. And the CDX, which is pretty much like the Game Shark Lite, but it has its own memory card device, and this is required for this one to run, as opposed to this one where it uses a standard VMU unit. Yeah, let's go ahead and crack one of these guys open, and I'll show you how to load them up. It really doesn't advertise that it plays imports, but yeah, these guys do. Now for this one here, the CDX Game Shark, you have to plug it into port 2, right there. So you also have room here for your VMU if you want to save games or whatnot. And you start off, of course, by popping in the Game Shark disc, powering it on. You notice it starts up there. Go ahead and skip that. Now here it says it's a licensed product, but after it boots up, it'll tell you that it isn't. Now it is required that you have that VMU or memory card in there to start this up. Otherwise, I'll tell you that it'll be looking for it. So if you ever purchase a CDX, make sure it comes with that. Now here, from start game, you want to go without codes, or if you do have codes, I guess you could play them with codes. Now come up with this menu here telling you to switch to disc. Now, this is actually a safe method to do disc swaps. If you notice, when I open it up, it comes to a complete stop. So, yeah, if you know anybody who does disc swaps while the disc is moving, I'll tell you straight up right now, eventually that motor on that spindle there is going to break. It's never ideal to swap disc when the disc is moving. But yeah, you place your import game in there and then hit OK, and the system will reset as if you just had turned on the power. Go ahead and skip that, but it'll load up just like any old regular Dreamcast game for your region. Saying I don't have a memory card there. Let's see, go ahead and skip all this here. But yeah, see. It loads up just fine.
Capcom, here we go!
Okay, the next one we'll try out here will be the Game Shark Lite. Now the Game Shark Lite, of course, like I said before, you will have to have a memory card in there. Now this one here, you can place, I do believe it expects it to be in the first slot, and you would do the same method here. Start up with a disk in the system. What's convenient about this particular one is if you have any codes, you get, they'll actually save onto here. Now, one thing you might want to note with this one is you want to make sure that you have, like, you actually look at one of the codes, and you can start it out without the codes or what. I'll run you through that right quick. See, select codes. You can select anything, pretty much. I have it on Battle Beaster here. And then, to start with the codes, I do believe you hit Start. Now here, I'll tell you, start game with codes or without codes. You want it without, and that's the same concept. The whole reason why you have to go to a game there is because it uses information off of the memory card, and if you don't select the game, it doesn't save anything on here, so you won't be able to run it straight off the back. But yeah, you'll see it save It'll say that it's saving when you select a game, regardless if you start with or without codes. And again, you hit OK, and it'll boot it right up. This is the one that I most commonly use, and it's probably a lot easier to find the GameShark Lite than the later versions. Yeah, let's go ahead and start that. And like before, it loads up just fine. Pretty simple, huh?
Oliver Kafka versus SNK2.
Okay, and the last one is probably the easiest one of the bunch, because you don't need any hardware from what I understand. I think all you need is a disc. But it's the same concept where you put in the disc and you switch it out. This one's kind of wacky because when it resets the system, you'll notice it kind of jitters, like at this point where it shows the Sega logo. But it's pretty straightforward here. It doesn't even use any language. So as you take the disc out, and once you press the open button, it tells you to place the disc in, so pretty straightforward. Probably the most convenient of the three. And there we go. Pop in the disc, and it should boot it up just fine. You don't have to press any buttons or whatnot. I guess you couldn't really notice, but yeah, it was actually shaking really fast from what I could see over here. I know my hand isn't steady either, so it probably balanced it out. But yeah, there you go. How to run imported titles.
This is SNK2.
On a standard Dreamcast, a US Dreamcast. Thanks again for watching, guys. I hope this has been helpful, and I'll talk to you guys next time.